असतो मा सद्गमय तमसो मा. In the central eastern part of India, about 270 kilometers away from Raipur, the capital of Chhattisgarh, lie the unknown hills. Surrounded on all sides by rivers and mountains, these vast tracts of land was once a very beautiful city, ruled by a benevolent king called Dand. Once angered with his very benevolence, Shukracharya, the mentor of demons, turned this lovely kingdom of Dand into a wild forest overnight. Since then, known as Abhujmar. The dense forests of Abhujmar historically remained an abandoned area since the time of the British. Even after independence, most parts of Abhujmar continue to be largely inaccessible to the outside world. These hills happen to be home to a predominant primitive tribe, the Abhujmarias. The hill Marias live in an inaccessible geographical terrain that remains cut off from the rest of the world during the rainy season. These hill Marias have been facing acute poverty and practicing a very primitive economy. Their literacy level is almost nil, and malnutrition and disease are rampant in these villages. The only cultivation they have known and practiced is slash and burn, known locally as Pinda Kheti. The major challenge was to reach these nomadic groups and solve their problems. Hence, the government decided to assign this task to a non-political, non-sectarian, spiritual organization, the Ramakrishna Mission, established by Swami Vivekananda, who engaged themselves in various forms of humanitarian and social service activities for more than a century. In 1985, the Ramakrishna Mission Ashram was established by Swami Atmanand in Narainpur, the last motorable land to the Abhujmar Hills. Along with its five service centers, the Ramakrishna Mission Ashram at Narainpur has brought more than 200 villages of Abhujmar area under its major scheme of services.
Ramakrishna Mission Ashram, Narainpur, is a branch center of Ramakrishna Math and Ramakrishna Mission, headquarters Belur Math, Howrah, West Bengal.
Since its inception, the ashram of working in the field of education, in the field of health, in the field of livelihood and rural development, and fourthly, in the field of preservation of culture and tribal culture and human values.
Education is the basic necessity to break free from the vicious thorns of poverty and to walk in symphony with the nation's development. Swamiji opined, if the poor cannot come to education, education must go to them. To achieve this ideology, a model residential school called the Ramakrishna Mission Vivekananda Vidyapeeth was established under the Gurukul system, where the values of home and educational institutions are blended together. The school holds to its credit 2,097 students, which includes 1,241 boys and 856 girls, 95% of which belong to the Maria community.
अभी तक हमारे 25 बैच यहाँ से निकल चुका है, करीब 1,300 बच्चे यहाँ पे से पास आउट हुए हैं, और उनमें से करीब 800 बच्चे ऐसे हैं जो अभी नौकरी कर रहे, सेटल हो गए हैं। उसमें से कोई इंजीनियर है, कोई प्रोफेसर है, कोई लेक्चरर है, ज़्यादातर टीचर बने हुए हैं और वो नारायणपुर के आसपास में ही है।
This campus runs on a public school pattern, exclusively for the boys and girls of the tribal groups. This model of higher secondary school offers its students 5 optional streams: science, commerce, arts, agriculture, and home science. In order to help the students with practical knowledge, the school has 4 modern laboratories. Its experience promotes their abilities to identify questions and concepts that guides them to scientific knowledge. The school has a separate section for the students studying in classes 1 to 5. The primary school of the ashram shares an enthusiasm for learning and a competitive spirit that shines through the noble minds of these tribal students. The ashram also provides a science playground, creating an enthusiastic learning experience for its elementary students. It enables them to learn about science in a way that enhances the creative experience and encourages the children to act. The ashram also has a play school for the early education of the children. It helps in building the physical, cognition, and emotional strength of these children. The Vivekananda Computer Training Center was started on the 29th of April 2008. Training students from class 6 onwards, these labs are equipped with the most modern systems, including projector-based learning, thereby creating an interactive environment for all its students. The library is the heart of any educational institution. The basement of the temple accommodates a library cum free reading room, helping the children to expand their horizons. It consists of 13,864 books, catering to the needs of the students of all the age groups in the ashram. It has a collection of ancient Vedic texts, helping the students stay rooted to our native system and values. In order to control the dropout rate of students from the school, special coaching centers called the Vivekananda Education Complex were started, with special emphasis on English, mathematics and science, bringing students from remote areas as far as 30 kilometers.
2006 में बंगाल में गया, जाकर देखा जी हमारे रामकृष्ण मठ मिशन के एक नया कार्यक्रम अपने अपने सामर्थ्य के अनुसार सब शुरू कर दिया। वो क्या है ना, कोचिंग सेंटर। तो एक नवंबर को इसका शुभारंभ किया गया। 184 बच्चों को लेकर, 5वीं, 8वीं और 10वीं बोर्ड परीक्षा के बच्चों को लेकर किया गया था।
As the students in these centers come from distant villages, the ashram provides them with free food and education-related necessities, including free transport. It currently serves more than 2,000 students in Narainpur and its surroundings. Swamiji proclaimed, Atmano Mokshartham Jagat Hitayacha. For one's own salvation and for the well-being of the world. Armed with this motto, the teachers of the ashram set out to the deep jungles of the remote areas to bring the children to the institution.
Kai gaon mein maine ruka aur dekha ki subah uthe teer dhanush hath mein liye 10-12 log ikattha hue aur selfie ped ke niche gaye, selfie piye aur jungle ghumna shuru kar diya. Aur jab humne un logon se baat kiya, tumhare bachche ko hum padhane ke liye aaye, kuch gaon mein itna positive baat sunne ko mila, sunke हंसी भी आया, खुशी भी हुआ। उनको कहा तुम्हारे बच्चे को हम पढ़ाना चाहते हैं, चलो गांव चलो, जंगल से इधर चलो गांव में आए हैं। उन लोगों ने कहने लगा आप जाके बच्चे लोगों को, पूरा बच्चे को ले जाओ, और हम लोग अभी नहीं जा सकते, हम लोग अभी शिकार खेलने जा रहे हैं।
The Ramakrishna Mission runs 2 middle and 3 primary schools in Akabeda, Kutul, Kachapal, Irakbatti and Kundla villages. The total strength of the students in these areas during the current academic session is 664. 85% of them are from the Abuj Maria community. The ashram has also constructed more buildings to cater to the higher studies of the students in the interior parts of Abuj Mar. Thus, furnishing these young minds with higher quality of education. The huge campus of the ashram has 3 separate hostel buildings for the boys. The hostel for the girls lies in another section of the campus. The campus houses 668 boys and 400 girls, ranging from class 1 to 12. The hostel creates an all-inclusive environment where students help each other in the day-to-day tasks. It also provides a large hall where the students can participate in active learning through constant interaction and consultations with each other. The students of the ashram are groomed in discipline and a spiritual way of life.
Thank you.
The homely landscape created by the ashram for these children not only yields better interaction, but also helps in shaping a disciplined environment. A month-long annual festival, popularly known as Anand Mela, is organized for all the students of Abujmar and Narainpur schools to encourage and develop their local culture and traditions. These multi-talented tribal children are encouraged to come forward and enlighten the people with their culture. The ashram holds a tribal youth convention where around 2,500 tribal children from different states come together to celebrate the diversity and integrity of the Indian culture. As the evening descends, the ashram awakes to the playful laughter of the children. It is said that a child who does not have the opportunity to play is cut off from a major portion of his childhood. The Vivekananda Vidyapeeth is not just an excellent educational center, but also stands out in sports. Apart from a number of playgrounds for the students, they also have a large indoor stadium accommodating an inbuilt gymnasium of national standards. Their fitness regime includes regular workouts under the guidance and supervision of professional coaches, encouraging the students to give their best to their favorite sport.
आज रामकृष्ण मिशन आश्रम नारायणपुर के करीब 50 बच्चे हर साल नेशनल गेम्स में जाते हैं खेलने के लिए बाहर.
These games are not restricted to just the boys of the ashram. The girls too take active part in all sporting activities. They practice and play regularly with an equal dedication and team spirit, be it khokho, basketball, volleyball, table tennis, badminton, and many more. Boys can be seen taking part in the sport of Malkhamb, an ancient Indian sport to sharpen the whole body and mind. The students of the ashram regularly participate and have won in many regional, state and national level competitions. Among the Abujmar tribes, women are considered as partner rather than a burden on the family. Swamiji once said, "If you teach a boy, you teach only one individual. Whereas by teaching a girl, you teach a whole family." With this principle in mind, Vishwas, a sister institution, was established in Orcha to impart value-based education to the tribal girls along with an intense physical and mental regime.
This school's a उद्देश्य था कि जहाँ पर बालिकाओं की जो literacy rate 2% है, वहाँ से उनको लेके एक model school की स्थापना करना है.
With the current strength of 264 girls at Orcha and 400 girls at Vivekananda Vidyapeeth, Narayanpur, Vishwas runs five other hostels within the ashram schools inside Abujamar. Under the Integrated Child Development Scheme, Vishwas runs 85 Anganwadis and 96 mini Anganwadis in the far-flung villages of Abujamar. In recognition of its meritorious services in the field of women and child development in Abujamar, Vishwas was awarded with the Mini Mata Award in 2002. Vivekanand opined, "Spirituality as a science, as a study, is the greatest and healthiest exercise that the human mind can have." Encouraged by this motive of thought, special value-based education classes are also conducted every Sunday in the temple of the ashram, holding discourses on teachings and lives of spiritual persons. This helps students to learn the importance of ethics and value systems in the society. To shape the inner confidence of the students, dignitaries from different fields are invited to share their experiences, also motivating the students to join the mainstream of the nation.
Neymar ho, Sachin Tendulkar ho, Rahul Dravid ho, apne apne khel mein 10 saal ke antaral mein, umar 10 se 20 21 ke beech mein 10,000 ghanta practice kiye hain.
Due to lack of basic education and healthcare, the tribal people of Abujamar have fallen prey to diseases like malnutrition and high mother-infant mortality rate. The primitive economy had forced them to practice black magic to cure themselves. Bringing them into the fold of modern medicine was a real challenge for the mission. Slowly leaving behind their orthodox convictions, the people are developing more confidence to come under the modern methods of treatment. And thus, to help these tribal villagers, the Vivekanand Arugyadham was set up in the ashram premises. A 30-bed, well-equipped hospital has both an inpatient and an outpatient department. The hospital has a fully functional labor room, blood bank, X-ray department, and a well-equipped modern pathology department. All the medical facilities that they receive are free of cost. Common medicines are also provided free to all OPD patients through the dispensary of the hospital. Around 50,000 tribals are treated in this hospital every year. In collaboration with the UNICEF, the mission runs the Abujamar Health Outreach Project to reduce high infant mortality rate. Six health posts have been set up in the remote villages of Abujamar, namely Akabeda, Irakbhatti, Kachapal, Kutul, Orcha, and Kundla. The mission also runs three Nutrition Rehabilitation Centers, or the NRC, in the interior of Abujamar, which has till date treated about 800 SEM children. The persistent dedication of the mission has helped bring more than 70% of the children to their normal health. For centuries, agriculture has not just been a means of livelihood, but a way of life for the tribal farmers. To improve upon their earlier farming techniques, the Ramakrishna Mission Ashram formed an agriculture training cum demonstration farm at Brehi Beda, named the Krishi Prashikshan Evam Pradarshan Kendra. The farm developed on a 52-acre plot at Brehi Beda, just 3 kilometers away from Narainpur, offers training in dairy, poultry, duckery, composite farming, horticulture and pisciculture, helping the farmers to enhance their knowledge. About 3,970 tribal farmers have benefited through the demonstrations conducted by the farm. Around 30 fish ponds were dug in the nearby villages of Narainpur for the development of fisheries in the area. About 35 training camps of both short and long duration were also conducted, benefiting around 7,221 farmers. To inspire the villagers to take up active farming, an agro-business and service center has been set up in conjunction with the Vivekanand Gram Seva Samiti, providing fertilizers, seeds, medicines, pump sets, spawn and fishing nets, benefiting 2,150 tribal farmers. Kisan Mela is one of the distinctive approaches by the Narainpur Ashram. This Mela has become a meeting ground where farmers interact with the students of agriculture, exchange knowledge and create awareness regarding green revolution, scientific and economic farming methods. In order to serve the daily needs of all the students, the ashram has built a mega kitchen and a bakery within its premises. It serves a large number of people every day, employing an exceptional cooking method, processing food grown from the farm cultivated within the ashram's premises. This mega kitchen is equipped with modern cooking technologies, where solar power is used in the preparation of food instead of natural gas. The ashram also has a goshala, providing protective shelter for the cows and takes good care of their overall well-being. The goshala has a total of 16 employees working in 3 different shifts. The milk from these cows are provided to the students and the staff working in the ashram. To curb economic exploitation of the tribal villagers and to provide the people with adequate stock of their day-to-day needs, the ashram has set up fair price shop at Narainpur.
जो daily needs होता है, ये तो सब यहाँ पे provide होता है लोगों को, वो भी reasonable rate. और दूसरी बात उसके साथ government का जो PDS system है, उसके द्वारा हमारे पास हम करीब 600 राशन कार्डधारियों को monthly राशन सामान regular supply करते हैं. और जो 5 दुकानें हमारी, वहाँ पर भी करीब 1200 राशन कार्ड है उनको सब राशन प्रोवाइड करते हैं
5 फेयर प्राइस शॉप्स हैव आल्सो बीन सेट अप इन द इंटीरियर विलेजेस ऑफ अबूजमार टू मीट देयर बेसिक नीड्स एंड मोर इंपॉर्टेंटली एट द राइट प्राइस द रामकृष्ण आश्रम एट नारायणपुर हैज एस्टैब्लिश्ड अ व्हीकल मेंटेनेंस डिपार्टमेंट व्हिच हेल्प्स इन मेंटेनिंग a continuous communication between the main ashram and the other centers in the interior villages. The Narainpur Ashram has opened various new opportunities for the tribal youth by setting up the Vivekananda Vanavasi Yuva Prashikshan Kendra, a residential training unit specially designed for the youth who are willing to take up new career demands in the field of welding, vehicle maintenance, motor driving, sewing, and carpentry. On the 1st of October 2012, the ITI, or Industrial Training Institute, was started with the aim of empowering the students with practical skills.
प्रारंभ में 300 बच्चों के लिए राज्य शासन ने निर्धारित किया था जो आज 350 बच्चों का क्षमता हमारी आईटी की बन गई है वर्तमान में हमारे आईटीआई में 10 स्टेट के 20 यूनिट में कुल 350 बच्चे जो प्रशिक्षणरत हैं उनको 70 टीचिंग स्टाफ और अन्य कर्मचारी मन समर्पण के साथ देखभाल कर रहे हैं और ट्रेनिंग दे रहे हैं
दिस आईएसओ सर्टिफाइड इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफर्स डिटेल्ड ट्रेनिंग्स related to tractor mechanism, driving cum motor mechanism, training as an electrician, welder, mason, craftsman, computer operator, and program assistant. 12-acre campus of ITI also provides a hostel accommodation for the tribal children coming from the remote areas of Abujmar free of cost.
यहाँ का फैसिलिटी बहुत अच्छा है यहाँ अनुशासन भी अच्छा है पढ़ाई भी अच्छा चल रहा है यहाँ का हॉस्टल का नियम भी कुछ अलग रहता है और अच्छा भी लगता है
As the students gradually come in proximity to the modern technology, A new light of hope shines through their virtuous soul, reinvigorating them with vigor and conviction. The accounts department of the ashram is managed by trustworthy and dedicated employees. They work round the clock, hence creating a base for successful execution of the projects undertaken by the ashram. Many eminent dignitaries have visited the ashram, enhancing the morale of the students since its inception in 1985.
We take this opportunity to thank Chhattisgarh state government and state central government for their help, cooperation and support. We thank our friends, devotees and well-wishers for their wholehearted support and cooperation. I pray to the Holy Trio for welfare of all. I thank to all.
As the sun sets in, the students march together to seek solace under the shadow of the eternal divine. This ashram is a symbol of universal faith and levity, providing a serene atmosphere for regular prayers, worship, and meditation to derive inner peace and bliss. Swami Vivekananda opined, To succeed, you must have tremendous perseverance, tremendous will. These robust pillars of the Ramakrishna Mission Ashram is a reflection to this very ideology and reminds us that with selfless service to humanity, one can bring the much needed change in the society. It is easy to build an institution within the vicinity of any metropolitan city, but to make it within the impenetrable and distant jungles of Abujamar needs vision, but more importantly, needs courage and zeal. The elementary work that Ramakrishna Mission is doing in the out-of-bound areas of Abujamar is not only the accomplishment of a visionary, but also the deed of creating a legacy in the history of mankind. A history that brings the people of Abujamar to the essence of humanity. A new narrative of development is being written in the turbulent roads of these perilous hills of Abujamar.